Welcome to the DCNR Grants Customer Service Portal. The portal is your one-stop shop for everything DCNR grants. You can apply for all of our grants through the portal, and you can manage awarded projects through it as well. For this video, we'll focus on how to use the portal to manage grants that you've already been awarded. We'll cover how to apply for new grants in a separate video. To access the portal, visit apps.dcnr.pa.gov/grants. The Grants Customer Service Portal works on most modern web browsers. Unfortunately, it is not currently compatible with Apple's Safari browser. When you arrive at the portal, your first step should be to sign in. Signing in to your account lets you access both your applications and awarded projects. Sign in using your username and password. If you've forgotten your username or password, you can use the Forgot Username or Password option to reset them. If you need to create an account, you can also do that from this screen. Once you're signed in, use the menus at the top to find all the applications and projects associated with your account. You can use the My Account tab to update your contact information, link your account with an associated organization, and change your password. For this video, we'll focus on how to manage grants you've already received, known as awarded projects. To view your awarded projects, click on Awarded Projects from the green menu at the top of the page. Awarded Projects shows you all the grants associated with your account. You can filter the list by project status to help you quickly find your open grants. Clicking on a project's title will take you to the detailed interface for that project. That interface is where you'll submit information to DCNR, including any documents that need review. It's also where you'll make payment requests. In this case, let's click on this awarded project, BRC-SR-27268. Once the project interface opens, use the menu on the left to navigate to different pages. Each page contains information about your project or ways to interact with it. Let's go through each of these menu items, starting from the top. Project Verification is your go-to source for quick information about your grant. You can quickly find important details, such as your scope of work, contract dates, and grant award amount. You can also find contact information for your DCNR project manager. This person is your first point of contact for any questions you may have about your project. Feel free to reach out to them by phone or email if you need help. Project Resources is a great location to get more detailed information about your project. You can access important documents, such as your award letter, grant agreement, and any payment requests you've made. You can also view correspondence associated with your project, such as startup and approval to proceed letters. Below these two categories are more general resources to help you as you manage your project. In the Project Resources section, you'll find links to administrative guidelines, policies, and other technical information. It's a good place to start if you have questions about grant requirements. Template documents, such as the final cost spreadsheet, are also usually found here. Finally, there's a set of outreach tools to help you spread the word about your project. You can find template press releases, event request forms, and a communications kit with tips on promoting your project. The project checklist is the beating heart of project management, and it's probably where you'll spend most of your time on the portal. The project checklist is customized for each grant, so don't be surprised if your checklist looks different from project to project or different from the checklist items that you see in this sample project for this recording. Each checklist item is completed in order, and they're organized into sections based on when they occur during the life of your grant. This makes the project checklist a great place to get an overview of all the tasks needed to finish your project. Each checklist item includes instructions, with more information on what needs to be done to complete it. The project checklist is also where you'll submit documents to DCNR. In general, you should not email documents to your DCNR project manager. Instead, documents should be submitted through the Grants Customer Service Portal using the appropriate checklist item. Notice the colored circles next to each checklist item. At a glance, you can see which items have been completed, are in review, or need revisions. If revisions are needed for any documents, comments from your DCNR project manager will also appear underneath the checklist item to let you know what changes are needed. To submit a document, click on the appropriate checklist item. In this case, let's click on Submit Copies of Any Subagreements. Inside each checklist item, you'll find instructions for it, as well as a spot to leave comments for your project manager and to upload the relevant documents. The next step is really important. Once you've uploaded the documents you want to submit, be sure to check this box to indicate that the documents are ready for review. After checking the box, also make sure you click Save to submit the documents to DCNR. Doing these steps will trigger an alert to your DCNR project manager to let them know that new documents are ready for review. Progress reports are another important part of communicating with DCNR about your project. Generally, progress reports should be completed every 6 months. You'll receive an email from the Grants Customer Service Portal when it's time to submit a progress report. To add a progress report, click the Add New Progress Report button. Then, just fill in the prompts and click Save to submit your progress report. You may find it helpful to type your progress report responses first in a word processing software such as Microsoft Word, then copy and paste them into the portal. If you need to make a major change to your project, such as adding a new scope item or requesting more funds, you'll need to do that through a contract amendment. Amendments are handled through the Amendments tab on the portal. However, before starting an amendment request, always contact your DCNR project manager first and get their perspective on how best to proceed. To request an amendment, click on the Request an Amendment button. Inside the amendment request, you'll be asked questions such as a description of the amendment, as well as what changes you want to make. For example, you may be making changes to the project scope or extending the contract end date. You'll also have to submit an official request letter on organizational letterhead. There's a lot more to amendments than we can cover in this brief video. If you think you may need an amendment, be sure to talk to your DCNR project manager for more information before making a request through the portal. When you're ready to request a payment, you'll do that through the Payments tab. Generally, a maximum of 2 partial payments up to 90% of the grant award may be made upon DCNR approval of costs. The final 10% of your grant is held until approval of the final payment request made at the end of the project. To request a payment, use the Request a Payment button. Follow the prompts to fill out your payment request. Identify the type and amount of the payment you're requesting. You'll also need to add account information for direct deposit. Note that the direct deposit information you submit must match what is registered for your organization with the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. There are links on this page if you need to update your account information with the Commonwealth. If you need to view any documents you've submitted for the project, use the Uploaded Documents tab. This is often a quicker way to find documents than searching through the project checklist. Note that this page will only show documents associated with the project, not the application. To view application documents, such as your original budget, access the application separately through the Submitted Application tab. Finally, under Project Access, you can see who else within your organization can view and edit your project. Very often, projects will be worked on by multiple people across an organization. Even if one person is serving as the project lead, other staff may be reviewing content or submitting documents through the project checklist. There are three categories of project users. Read-only users can view the project, but they cannot make changes to it. Those with editing access can complete checklist items, upload documents, and submit progress reports. Only those with ownership access can submit payment and amendment requests or share the project with other users. To share your project, click on the Assign New User button. Within Assign New User, you can view a dropdown of all the people at your organization who have accounts on the Grants Customer Service Portal. Note that to add a person to your project, that person must have an account on the portal and they must be associated with your organization. Otherwise, their name will not show up in the dropdown list. Once you have selected the person you want to add, use the checkboxes to assign the permissions you want to give that person. Projects can have as many editors and owners as desired. Be sure to click Save to save your changes. If you need to remove a user from a project, you can also do that from the Project Access page. Simply click on the person's name. You can change that person's access permissions by using these radio buttons and then clicking Save. You can also remove the person entirely by clicking Delete. You now have a basic overview of the DCNR Grants Customer Service Portal, the one-stop shop for managing all your DCNR grant projects. Remember, if you ever have questions about your grant, don't hesitate to contact your DCNR project manager. Their contact information will always appear on the left side of the portal in the navigation bar. If you have technical questions about the portal, you can also contact the DCNR Grants customer service team by using the Contact Us button in the upper right of the screen. Simply fill out the prompts and click Send Message to contact the team. Thank you very much, and enjoy your time on the DCNR Grants customer service portal.